Hi, everybody, and welcome to this virtual open day for the MA Journalism of the University of the Arts London, particularly the London College of Communication. My name is Alejandro Abraham Manoyel, and I'm actually one of the tutors who will be teaching in this master course. I will be the pathway leader of the social justice journalism path. As we'll discuss in a minute, you'll see that this particular master offers three different pathways, and I will be kind of taking the lead on the social justice journalism pathway. But as you will see, we'll have a variety of professors and lecturers and readers who will all be very keen of welcoming you and taking you in this journey of learning about journalism in one of the best universities in London. Why London College of Communication? As you might know, our college has a rich history and has been kind of at the center of the development of the creative industries in the UK, particularly in publishing, but also in journalism and in media in general, really. Kind of the communication sector all around the world is evolving very fast. And we believe that the courses that we offer and also the practices that we take part on are really at the cutting edge of media journalism and publishing. London College of Communication is a structure having three different schools. We have the School of Media, the School of Screen, and the School of Design. This particular master, the Masters in Journalism, is part of the Media School. And London College of Communication is actually located in a very diverse and vibrant and fun part of London, really. Lots of our students have that kind of at the forefront of their mind when they decide to come to study with us. Because London is, of course, a world capital where there are a lot of opportunities for people to work in the media. And kind of the college itself, it's really at the center of it. There are lots of cultural institutions around it, and there is an excellent kind of transport link. We try to kind of enable our students to develop their own skills to succeed as future-facing creatives through our industry-focused courses. And as you will see, and hopefully you will experience, we really encourage collaboration, not just within the school and within the college, but also with the industry as a whole. Again, as you may know, our university consists of different colleges, and London College of Communication is part of this University of the Arts. And it's a very diverse body with over 18,000 students from 130 countries. I've been teaching at LCC for a number of years, and I cannot even remember the different kind of nationality students that I have taught. And we're very proud also to be ranked the second in the world for art and design as a university, according to the World University Ranking in 2020. So as I said, we are at the forefront both of practice, but also research and teaching. The Media School, where you will be located, has a comprehensive portfolio that spans a lot of different disciplines. So the actual Department of Journalism has a publishing arm, where there is also a master's in publishing. And the whole idea is that once you come to London College of Communication, independently of the topic that you're studying, you will have the opportunity to collaborate, but also just to have connections with people who are working in other areas of the media, including advertising, public relations, media and communication, photography, and of course, journalism. So we really encourage connections, because I think one of the things that master students are looking for, and I imagine that's what you're also applying to your university, is that network that will enable you to, you know, enter the workforce and progress in your career. So networking sits also at the heart of what we're trying to do. And not just with people who are doing exactly the same courses as you are, but also with people, as I've said, in other media related industries. The master's you will be applying is a master's in journalism, and that's how your title would be. But we are offering for the first time this year, three different pathways. And what we are trying to do here is to allow students to specialize in a particular area of journalism. Although there are different pathways, you will all be part of a single master program, and there will be plenty of opportunities for you to interact and to talk to other members of staff. The work that you will be doing, the collaborative work, as I will describe, is something that will take part across the three pathways. And one of kind of the big selling points, or one of the things that we are most proud in our program, is our very strong content offering that takes the form of Artifact. Artifact is, as I'm going to describe in a minute, a kind of multimedia brand which encompasses the practical work conducted by students during the time with us. And the three pathways will come together to work in the magazine and to collaborate in other projects. So of these three pathways, I will spend a little bit of time describing each of them. The first one is called MA Journalism, Arts and Lifestyle Pathway. And it's important to mention this is the only arts and lifestyle journalism course in the UK. It is a unique offering that combines interest in culture, but with a big emphasis in long storytelling. We traditionally have attracted students who are very interested in fashion, but also perhaps in travel, different areas of consumer culture, also popular culture. And we are committed to experimentation, creativity, and original storytelling. We are really not a news course, we are more a feature course. And what we are trying to do is give you the opportunity to apply the journalistic skills and the journalistic frameworks to your passions. So we are very open for you to explore your particular interest in the area of lifestyle journalism, and just provide you with the skills and the tools for you to be able to produce professional content that can be presented as an industry level, and that can open up opportunities for you to work in the media. We are, of course, interested in teaching all the professional skills while avoiding allowing students to have their own individual voice. And as I said, in the past, we have had students who are very much interested in fashion, and they have launch their own magazines, or people who are interested in food, for example. Recently, we have one student that started producing content for Vice, all about food and street food in particular. People in the past have written about travel journalism, but also wellness and mental health. So issues that kind of combine the cultural aspect with the lifestyle aspect. And as I said, what a better place to study these than in London. The second pathway, which this year will be the first time that we're offering, is called a Master's in Social Justice Journalism. And the idea here is we recognize that journalism as a discipline is changing, that perhaps traditional understandings of objectivity are being challenged by the need of journalists to perhaps change the world. So the course explores kind of how journalism can make the world a better place through topics such as climate change, gender and racial equality, poverty, and other topics. We are also in the media school, but particularly in the journalism and publishing department. We host the Refugee Journalism Project for the last 5 or 6 years, which works with a number of media companies to help refugees to restart their professional careers in the UK. As a master's student, you will have the opportunity to collaborate with this project. So if migration, refugee, and asylum seeker is a topic that you are passionate or interested, there is a lot of connections. But of course, it's not the only topic. And just like lifestyle journalism, lifestyle and arts journalism, allows you to choose a path and a topic and your passion, we are very keen to offer this particular pathway to students that have a particular interest in an issue that they want to explore. This course, as I said, attempts to also connect students with organizations and individuals who are trying to make the world a better place, while at the same time grounding their work in the at least professional standards of mainstream journalism. And the third pathway which you will be able to choose. It's called MA Audio Video Journalism. And it draws from the successful broadcasting pathway that already exists in the BA journalism and from substantial staff expertise. In a minute, I will talk about a little bit about the staff, but many of them have years of professional experience working in a diversity of large news organizations. And so the course will teach you the skills to tell stories using different audio and video formats, such as short-form documentaries, creative podcasting, and social media content. Just recently, we have upgraded our audio studios, and we are starting to produce podcasts to the highest quality. So if podcast is something that you're interested, you will be able to become an expert in the technical aspect of it, but also in the storytelling and cultural element of it. And as I said, we are not traditional broadcasting course. We're trying to use these skills for you to be able to tell your stories. So long format kind of features is the objectives that we can set for you to accomplish. The learning outcomes, of these units, what we are trying for you to be confident with the technical aspect, but also to know, as I've said already, the different elements for a successful story, from aspects of narrative development, but also use of sources, different voices, finding your own writing and creative spaces. So we are trying to provide you with the skills for you to develop your own practice. So London College of Communication has lots and lots of useful facilities. But perhaps before I tell you a little bit about it, Steve, you might be able to share with the students a poll. It will be just interesting for me to know of these three pathways, which one are you thinking of applying? As I said, you will all apply to the master's, but then you will have to decide of these three pathways, which are you most interested in. So if you want to quickly fill in the poll, that will be great for me. Okay. So Steve, where would I be able to see the poll results?
Hi, Alejandro. I'm sorry, I thought it would be showing on the screen, but I will talk you through the results. Arts and lifestyle journalism is 63%. Audiovisual journalism is 13%. Social justice journalism is 19%. And all pathways equally is 6%.
Excellent. So as I said, you still have opportunity for you to decide after you have applied. Although, as I said, you will be located in a particular pathway, and we'll discuss a little bit more how this the course is structured, you will be able to interact with members of staff of all different pathways and also with students. There will be opportunities for also for you to explore some of the topics that are covered in different pathways. But the idea is that at the end, you will be able to specialize in a particular area. So the facilities that we offer at London College of Communication are very varied, and they are kind of cutting edge. We have 3D workshops and creative technology lab. Of course, we have a canteen and a cafe for you to socialize. There are kind of shops in which you can buy all the kind of requirements and elements that you need to for your creative practice. And we have a very well-stocked kit room. I just recently mentioned also our audio studio. And all of these spaces, you will be able to use some of them during your master's as part of your normal course. But all of them are also open to any LCC student. You might need to take some course or introductory course, but if for whatever reason you would like to work on 3D printing and that's something that you are interested in, perhaps not completely or directly connected to your master's, you still will be able to do it. London College of Communication, in the past it was called London College of Printing. So we have a long tradition of printing and physical kind of printmaking. And in the past, students have really enjoyed kind of getting their fingers with ink and use these big lithographic machines. So hopefully your master will be at the center of your university experience, but you will also be able to explore other perhaps creative avenues that you might be curious or interested in. So you will be taught by highly experienced and well-regarded staff team. Your tutors are professionals with multi-platform experience. Again, as I mentioned, gain at national newspapers, websites, the BBC, Sky TV, Al Jazeera. And you will develop key practical journalistic skills to learn how to apply them to your particular area of interest. And you will also be taught by academics with a strong research and publishing record. So this is a practical course, which will, as I said, equip you with the skills for you to be able to shoot and to film and to write. But it is also an academic course in which you will explore ideas, read interesting text, engage with concepts that will make your own practice richer. Some of the people who will be teaching you, I can tell you a little bit about Lucia Bondavich, who is actually the course leader. So she is the person in charge of the master, and you might have a lot of contact with her once you apply. She has a PhD in media and communications and art. She's very interested in lifestyle journalism. She will be the pathway leader of that particular pathway. She is very international and has a lot of experience taking students to some of the most interesting cultural areas in London to produce also interesting work. Some other members of staff that might be worth for you to know about: Simon Hind, who is the program director of journalism and publishing. He had a long and distinguished career in journalism. He worked for Sky News for many years. Vivian Francis, who used to work for the BBC. She is the reader in social justice journalism, and also she is a reader in knowledge exchange, and is the person in charge of the refugee journalism project. She has lots of connections with the industry, but also with lots of grassroots organizations. And Linda Smith, she's a senior lecturer in journalism, also an ex-BBC broadcaster. She had a lot of experience with audio. And her interests are also very much connected to lifestyle journalism, including, for example, you might want to know, she is a highly regarded yoga practitioner and teacher, and she brings some of her passions to her teaching. One of the things that we want to accomplish with these masters, even if it has different pathways, is that collaboration again sits at the center of this offering. And collaboration at all levels. So UEL has a strong ethos of collaboration. There are many ways in which we apply these to our course, including the collaborative unit, and we're going to be discussing that. So I see collaboration as something that happens at different levels. Perhaps at the basic level, you will be collaborating with all your classmates, with all your year students, with your members of the publishing and journalism department. We also offer a master's in publishing. So very often, particularly for the final major project, master students collaborate with the publishing students in order to put together the physical magazine, one of the elements of Artifact. But we also are very keen for you to collaborate with industry. So we run a number of events during the year in which we bring practitioners to talk to students. We encourage not just one-off interactions, but to establish your network, your professional network. This image is from an event that we run every year that is called Meet the Experts, that runs a little bit like speed dating, but with experts. So you will have time to talk in a very relaxed environment. You can see there are people having a beer with people who work in the media to present your ideas, to ask about their own practices and perhaps even opportunities in their own institutions. And that happens as a way of easing you in the industry and the professional practice that you will find yourself after graduating. These experts do not come just to offer kind of their connections, but they also do offer their expertise. We run a regular guest speaker season in which we bring practitioners, and we are very keen to connect our own teaching to what they bring to the table. So it's not just that you're going to be listening to interesting people talking about their own experiences and practices, but we're going to be linking our own teaching to those lectures and events, so that you can see the connection and you can see the clear link between what we are teaching to what you will be doing. So students will be able to take part of real life briefs. In the collaborative unit, you will be working closely with either an organization or another news organization. For people on the social justice journalism, we're keen for you to start to interact with activists and NGOs, people in the lifestyle and arts journalism. We are keen for you to start to, you know, link perhaps with brands, but also with perhaps cultural institutions. And the idea is that at the end of your studies, you will have a large network that you can rely on and that you can start to build your career. But as I said, although this is a kind of prominently and primarily a practical master's that will give you the skills, we also offer kind of a theoretical and a research offering. All the courses are hands-on, but informed by research and critical thinking. And just as I said, our staff are experts in their field. Lucia, who as I mentioned is the course leader, just a couple of years ago published the book Lifestyle Journalism, which is one of the first books to academically and kind of scholarly research into what lifestyle journalism is. So she's very well regarded and has lots of connections in kind of in this world, really. We in the past we've also kind of encouraged students to do research on their own and to find topics that can inform their journalism. Recently we have had events, for example, at the Lesbian and Gay Media Research Archive, which is a fascinating place. Students in the past have also collaborated with different institutions and museums in London. And the idea is that students who are inclined to do research will be able to explore big theoretical and conceptual areas and then bring that information to their own practice. As you know, journalism benefits also from academic research. One of the things that we are also keen to do as an art school and as an art college, really, is to show off and you know, disseminate the work that students do. So after graduating, we have a big event in which students are able to kind of have a physical representation of their work and show it as an art show. In the past, students have had kind of journalists come to these events to read their material or to listen and to watch their content. And we also have recently also instituted a virtual showcase in which students can host their material. And it's a very nice way for you to, you know, present your material to possible employers. These showcases and these kind of events, both physical and online, are again another example of how we bring industry to college and how this collaboration between master's students and professional spaces is at the forefront of our thinking and our teaching. So what do graduates say about these masters? Well, we've had a very good experience of students really appreciating what we had to offer in the past, but also feeling that they belong to London College of Communication and, in fact, coming back to us. We, in the past, have also invited graduates to come back and to talk to new students about their own experience. And some of them have even ended up working with us. as either associate lecturers or as experts. So it's always a moment of pride when graduates come back and tell their stories, really. I can tell you a little bit about Dalia Dawood because I worked closely with her. She graduated from the Master's Lifestyle Journalism 4 years ago. And since then, she has had kind of an incredible career. She's worked with a number of institutions, including, as I said, Vice, Reuters, the Financial Times, as a kind of freelance journalist, but also she's come back to us and has worked as an associate lecturer. And she recently was featured in an article in The Guardian in which she explains kind of the benefits of her starting a master's after having kind of a successful professional career. Because we are aware that some of you might come directly after finishing your BA or other studies, but some of you might also come from industry and you want to kind of reorient or perhaps upscale. So this is something that we are very aware and very keen to be a master that is useful and that is challenging, both for people who have just continued their academic career or those who have who are coming kind of from an industry environment. Some quotes, Sue from Malaysia, she graduated 2 years ago. She said that she's, I'm back in London, I'm quoting here, after returning home, working as assistant producer in Sky. Some of the Sky original shows that I have worked on are Chernobyl, Riviera, Catherine the Great, Temple, and most recently Britannia Season 2. And this is something also that we find quite often. Students with the skills that we provide are equally confident working in straight-up journalism and producing, you know, features and content. But also the skills are transferable, so they are very often ending up in other media-related industries. So that opens up the opportunity for you to pursue your career in different areas. So we always want students to continue doing journalism, but it's good to know that you will have also the skills to work in PR or in advertising or in other kind of media-related industries. Fee from Singapore just graduated last year. She says, I work for one of the leading food writers in Singapore, said Louis. I also run the lifestyle content of the site Hype and Stuff, writing reviews, researching current lifestyle trends, and liaising with clients to promote products and services. So we also have that kind of that richness, I suppose, of our master, that many of our students have a very international background. And some of them decide to stay in London and to pursue opportunities here, but many others also go back to the countries and really show off what a British education, and particularly at LCC education, can do for their careers. So we're always very keen to keep that contact. And again, that's another level of collaboration, the collaboration that happens between current students and graduates. The university is very aware that students sometimes need support, especially if they are coming to London for the first time, or if they are a bit unsure on kind of their position. So there is a lot of academic support, but also kind of student support in general. And one interesting space is what we call the Postgraduate Hub. And the Hub is designed to provide information to students transitioning into their MA courses, but also they provide careers and employment advice for existing students and provide ongoing teaching and learning support and guidance. So you will be supported. Some of you might be a bit nervous or hesitant to start your master's, although I'm sure all of you are also very excited. So there will be plenty of support for you to really make the most out of this experience. Something that is also quite innovative and quite useful, and it's something that happened at the LCC and University of the Arts London level, is a graduate residency program. So successful candidates, once they graduate, receive support from LCC, including funding, access to create a creative community, expert support, and also the use of office meetings and technical spaces. There are lots of our students are quite entrepreneurial. So many of them actually launch their own magazines or their own podcasts or their own kind of businesses, really, while finishing their master's. Or immediately after it. LCC and UEL offer this residency program as a way of encouraging that entrepreneurial sense. Another interesting scheme is the industry mentoring scheme. Again, this is in addition to the events that happen within the course. This is at a UEL level. And the industry mentoring scheme connects postgraduate students of all disciplines, really, with industry professionals to support the development as they enter the media and creative industries. At the moment, we are working quite closely with VICE and the Reuters, Thomas Reuters Institute. So our college, but also our school, have a number of close connections with particular news organizations and media companies that offer mentoring, which, as I said, I think is one of the best ways for students to start to develop their own networking. So that's pretty much what we had prepared for you. You will now need to apply. The application process is pretty straightforward, and we just require some information from you. You will need to produce a personal details. You will need to tell us your full name, your nationality, and permanent address and English language level. You will produce upload on a platform your CV and employment history. And all of this is for us to get to know you before you come here. And it will be great for you to also produce a portfolio. And sometimes we also ask for a student study proposal and a personal statement. And again, this will be information that will be useful for us to understand where you are coming from and also to be ready to welcome you all in. For more information on making an application, and particularly your personal statement and portfolio advice, visit each course page and look under the headline "How to Apply." So there is plenty of information online, and in the next slide you will also be able to see lots of particular email addresses in which you can email for particular questions. Just for you to know, there is deadline for your application, which is the round two, which is the 13th of April. So we recommend that you submit your application as early as possible so that we'll have the chance and the opportunity to revise and also to invite you for an interview. Those interviews are opportunities for you to ask more direct questions. They are one-on-one, to discuss your interest and to talk about your portfolio. They are very friendly, so please don't be intimidated or afraid of those interviews. They are conducted by active members of staff. If for whatever reason you are not able to complete your application by the deadline of, I repeat, the 13th of April, please get in contact with us. There might be an opportunity for you to apply again, although we are not guaranteeing that there will be a space for you. So 13th of April, that will be a date for you to keep in mind. As I said, we are a very friendly bunch. So if you have general inquiries or questions, these are some of the contacts that you can send an email to. And I think now we are gonna move to the question and answer session. I hope that you all wrote some questions in your in the box, and I'll look forward to answer many of them.
Hi, Alejandro. Steve here. Thanks so much for that presentation. We do have some questions in the question box, so I'll go through those one by one and just remind everyone who's here with us today to write them down in the question box if they do have any other thoughts they'd like to get from you. So okay. The first question is regarding the audio video journalism pathway. Would you be able to advise on the kind of backgrounds that students would be encouraged to apply from? In particular, would a degree in filmmaking be something that we would be looking for on that pathway?
That's a great question. To be honest, we are inviting applicants from any type of background. We have, as I said before, staff with lots of experience. So if you already have a background in filmmaking or television studies, and you know how to use equipment, you can upskill your abilities, hopefully also explore different techniques, but also different tools and equipment. But if you have never actually done any kind of practical work, we'll take you by the hand and we'll do one by one. So there is no technical requirements for applying to that particular pathway. It really is an opportunity for students to get confident at their level and be able to produce content that is professional. So as I said, if you have experience, well, we'll definitely give you kind of additional task and additional work for you to do. If you've never actually picked up a camera, don't worry, we'll teach you how to do it.
Lovely, that's great, thank you. Would you be able to advise on the study schedule, in particular, how the week would be structured and what expectations there might be in terms of commitments to come into the building and to attend classes?
Yeah, that's a great question as well. So the way that we've structured the master's is a combination of practical units alongside theory units. There is an expectation that students will be in college. Perhaps from time to time, there will be events that happen online. But unless anything changed regarding the COVID situation, students are encouraged to be in college and to be there often. In the past, and of course, it depends on when in the course you are being kind of you're starting. At some moments, there are three units running at the same time. At times, there are two. So I think as a rule of thumb, students are expected to be present at least 3 days a week. Although, as I said, it depends on where exactly you are in the career or in the structure of the master. As I said, this is a full-time master, so you are encouraged to devote your entire time and attention to it. But in the past, we have also students that combine these with perhaps some freelancing or some other activities. So I suppose that how much is required also depends on how much you want to take out of the course. So students are encouraged to give it its best and give it it all. And being in college, we also try to generate a sense of community. So the more you are in these beautiful spaces at LCC, the best. But if you have other commitments or if you have part-time work, there are also ways of accommodating your schedule to that.
Lovely, thank you. I have a question from someone in the audience, which is about the portfolio. It's quite a specific question, but I'll make this slightly more general. But student is interested in, obviously interested in the course and has a relatively practical BA. But wanted to know what kind of things you would be looking for in the application itself, what kind of experience you would be looking for, how relevant that might need or how directly relevant that might need to be to journalism itself. Mm-hmm. And I guess maybe it's an opportunity just to go into a bit more detail about the kind of students that we think would benefit from the course, and the kind of students we're looking for on each of the pathways.
Yeah, that's great. So, I mean, what we are looking for is really passionate students that have kind of an interest in journalism and in media. I can tell you a little bit about the portfolios in the past that I've reviewed and I've interviewed. So students very often present some content that they have produced, short features, links to any video or audio material that they have put together. We also encourage students to present some information on kind of any theoretical work that they have done, any essays that they have written, they're proud. Perhaps if you have already your BA dissertation and you want to show off your results, that's something that you can also share. There is more information about what exactly we are looking in the portfolio on the links that we have mentioned before. However, if your background is in a discipline that perhaps doesn't it doesn't result in lots of content for you to present, I think just any evidence or any examples of your writing would be useful on any kind of creative outlet that you've had. So as I said, in the past, students have also presented photographic essays that they have produced or creative writing that they have put together. So we are quite flexible, although we are expecting students to, you know, to talk about issues that they are passionate and they are interested in. In your personal statement and in your CV, you will also be able to talk about your general interests, not particularly only journalism. So if what we want to do with these interviews is to get to know you as a person and to really see what it is that you have to offer also to the master's. So I'm a bit unclear, but the idea is for you to present things that perhaps you're proud of, things that you have produced in your BA, if you have a professional experience, anything that has to do with your professional practice. It will, you know, the platform allows you to also add links. So if there is things that are, you know, hosted outside and you cannot kind of print, it will be the opportunity for you to add the link and just describe it, and then we'll go and have a look at it. So hopefully that kind of make the process a little bit less scary or nervous making.
That's great, thank you. And can I, just to be absolutely clear for another one of our inquirers, it's entirely okay to just submit a portfolio which is just writing, is that okay?
It is entirely okay, that's right. So perhaps something that students should know is that independently of the pathway that you take, you will all have some audiovisual training and you will learn to use the kit. So in the past, the master's has perhaps had a kind of a tendency of producing written work, but this new iteration will also give the opportunity to students to explore audiovisual content production. So if the only thing that you have produced is something in the written format, it is completely fine. If, as some of you might be having experience with filmmaking and you want to show some of your shorts or whatever you have produced, you can also do it. So there is no specific technical requirements for applying to this course.
Lovely, thank you. Could you summarize or estimate the balance between theory and practice on each of the pathways?
Yeah, I think all the pathways have one main theory course, which is called Critical Approach to Lifestyle Journalism or Critical Approach to Social Justice Journalism. And that course kind of introduces the concepts and give the historical approach to these places. However, I would say that perhaps the theory element will encompass no more than one third of the units. And these theory units are completely devoted for you to have the language and the historical context to explore your practical content production and develop your skills. So this is not just reading theory and concepts and books in order to test you on how to write essays. This is for you to be equipped with the the historical and theoretical concepts that will be useful for you to discuss topics that you are interested in. So for example, in the social justice journalism pathway, we have a week in which we discuss what environmental journalism is, the history of it, how it is different from science journalism. We spend some time discussing the history and struggles of the LGBTQ plus community, or we talked about peace journalism, something that perhaps is very important and current at the very sad moments that we are living, how peace journalism is different from war journalism. But all of this is for you to have the tools so that once you go to do your practical work, you can inform your journalism in an interesting way. The same with the rest of the pathways in the lifestyle journalism pathway, there is a lot of emphasis on understanding audiences as something that is interactive and different from the audiences of the past. We talked about reviewers and culture makers. What does it mean to have taste? We talked about high and low culture and how that kind of impact the type of journalism that's being produced. So these theories and concepts, as I said, they're all, this unit in general is all designed so that it will enrich your practical work. However, if you are very academically inclined and theoretically minded, there are also opportunities for you to pursue that. Your final major project is a practical piece of work, but it can be supported by some academic research. In the past, we have had some students that have applied and been interested in doing PhDs. So if that is something that you're also interested, the college will support you, and there will be opportunity for you to continue. I hope that reassure people who are perhaps not very keen on the theory aspect, but also those who are interested in perhaps a more academic career.
Lovely, thank you. And I've got two questions that I'll try and combine into one. There's a question about graduate outcomes and how the percentage of students that go on to work in journalism and other related disciplines. I realize it's a new course, that might be quite difficult to estimate, but would you also be able to, you know, do your best to answer that one, but also more generally outline the ways in which the course will support people to find opportunities, graduate opportunities after they leave the course?
Yeah, sure thing. Just as you said, because it's a revalidated course, we don't have the data on students' employment. But in the past, we've had very strong numbers for the previous validated course. If I remember correctly, at least a third of students find jobs within the first 3 months of graduating. Again, this will be something that perhaps we can follow up if students are interested in particular numbers. I know that there is a way for us to get that information. But we are very proud of our success in placing students in really interesting and related companies. And something that also is quite remarkable is the number of opportunities that come our way. So we are a very well-regarded institution. So very often companies come to us directly and offer paid job to some of our students. So I can honestly say that at least once a week, you will receive an email from very often from Simon or program director saying, TikTok is looking for somebody to produce some content. Actually, this happened just last week. We had as a guest speaker somebody in management on TikTok. I don't have his name. And after the talk, he discussed a working opportunity and an internship opportunity with Simon. And then Simon sent an email to all graduates, all students, saying there is an opportunity. You can apply. This is the process. And this happens constantly. So very often students end up already with work experience while they are doing their master's. As I said, we're very proud on the success of our graduates, and one way in which we see this is the number of students who come to our masters, particularly the lifestyle journalism that has a longer history. In the past, we've had a very good very good reputation, and people are starting to talk about our masters as a place to come to be part of the growing lifestyle journalism environment and industry.
Lovely, thank you. And in terms of supporting people in entrepreneurship skills and setting themselves up a freelance, there's definitely support within UAL in the Careers and Employability Service, but is that also something that's addressed on the course?
Yes, we do have one unit that is called Preparing for Industry, and that unit it's running almost the last few months of the MA, in which we kind of provide support and guidance on how to apply to positions, where to look for them, how to create your portfolio so that it's attractive to possible employers. And as I said, many all our members of staff have connections within the industry. So very often also is, well, I know somebody that might be interested in what you're doing. Why don't you send a line? And this unit really equips you with everything that you need so that you feel supported in that scary step of from graduation to finding your first position. So you will be supported, and as I said, it will be support you, it will be support coming from UEL, but also from college, and also from particular tutors and lecturers that you might approach for their particular expertise.
Wonderful, thank you. I just have one further question actually, and it's about the application process, but it would be really useful if you could just summarize maybe the kind of the steps that people will take from their initial application to portfolio submission to interview. And do they happen simultaneously or are they sequential?
Yeah, that's great. So maybe I can go back to the slide. So once you apply, you need to submit a number of documents. And as I said, perhaps the three most important documents or the ones that will require the most of your time will be your personal statement, in which you will just tell us a little bit about yourself, why you are passionate about journalism, a little bit about your academic history, but also your professional history. Then you will have a proper CV in which we can see your trajectory and then your portfolio. You will submit this and upload it, to a platform. And then once we receive that, members of staff will review this application and then we'll invite you to an interview. We'll give you plenty of opportunity for you to schedule this interview. It usually happens once you submit your application in a couple of days or perhaps a week, you will receive an invitation for you to come to an interview. And then we'll conduct the interview. And if the interview goes well and you're still happy to apply, then we'll offer you a place. And we can offer you a place with conditions, particularly for those who haven't graduated yet. So your position, the place will be offered to you on the condition that you will either graduate or perhaps if English is not your first language, that you present your language level. And once we make the offer, you will be able to accept it or decline it, and then you'll come to us. So the steps are pretty straightforward. You upload the documents required to the platform. You wait for us to offer you an interview. Then we take part in this. By the way, it's a short interview. It's a 30-minute interview. And then you will receive an offer, either a conditional or a non-conditional offer. So it's not scary. And as I said, we are a friendly bunch. You can always also contact us directly.
Thank you so much. That's the last of our questions. So I just want to thank you, Alejandro, for the presentation. It was really, really useful overview of each of the pathways. So thank you so much. And I'll hand over to you now just to say some final words before we end the session.
Excellent. Well, just to assure everybody that you will be very welcome and very well supported in this master's. We are very excited about the opportunity to offer these three different pathways. As I said, independently of the pathway that you choose, you will be able to interact with students who are passionate and that have something to say. In the past, we've been also very impressed of how strong the community among students become. And so you will hopefully also make friendships and relationships that will last for the rest of your life. London is an exciting city. It's waking up after the pandemic. So I'm sure you will be excited to take advantage of all the opportunities that London has to offer. And well, just to remind everybody that the University of the Arts London is really at the forefront of arts education. And you will get great opportunities. We really look forward to meeting you all.